Now in part 5 I will discuss with the topic on the topic rate constant. In the previous part I have shown you that how law of mass action is helping us to write the rate equation for a reaction. Though it has some limitations, it is not matching with the experimental observed rate equations for a multi-step reaction. Yet, the importance of law of mass action is it is helping you to write the rate equation for any reaction. Now, while constructing the rate equation for any reaction, say this one. So here we have A molecules, A moles of A reacting with B moles of B to give you product. Now as per law of mass action, the rate is proportional to this reactant when concentration of B was kept constant, and it is proportional to concentration of B to the power B when this was kept constant. And when we have both the terms varying, then it was like this. Now later we find that when we perform experiment, we get that this stoichiometric coefficient may not be the order, that is molecularity of a reaction may not be the order of a reaction. So better, keeping in mind of the mismatch, we replace A by alpha and replace B by beta. That would be the correct approach. Now when we replace this proportionality by equal to, a proportionality constant will come, which I have referred to as the rate constant. Rate constant. Now why that is a constant? You are accustomed to tell it as constant, since whenever you find that y is proportional to x and you write y equal to kx, you say that k is the proportionality constant. Now this particular constant is carrying within it the most important features regarding a reaction. So don't ignore it, that it is a proportionality constant. Don't ignore. This dependency of rate of any reaction with respect to reactant is true for every reaction. But on what parameters reaction will vary? The reaction will vary with respect to the order of the reaction with respect to reactants, and it will vary by this rate constant. So for different reactions there will be different rate constant. So rate constant is going to characterize a particular reaction. So it is an important part of a chemical equation that involves the rate. So it is an important part of the rate equation. Now see, we have rate for any concentration of A and B. If we perform experiment, if you take third bracket A, that is concentration of A to be 0.1 mole per liter, and concentration of B to be 0.1 mole per liter, that is going to give you a rate. And if you change it by 0.2, that is also give you another rate. So changing the concentrations, you will get different kinds of rate. But if you choose like third bracket A equal to 1.0 molar and third bracket B equal to 1.0 molar, so you are choosing that both the concentration is unity, then we have
rate equals to k into, this is 1.0 to the power alpha and 1.0 to the power beta. So we have k equals to rate.
So we can write rate constant is actually the rate. We can write rate constant is, and it is actually the rate when concentration of the reactants are unity. So this is the definition of this rate constant. So when you put third bracket A to be 1.0 and concentration of B to be 1.0, you have rate equals to K. So the rate corresponding to the unit concentrations of the reactants, the rate corresponding to the unit concentration of the reactants is the rate constant. So I am writing K is the rate constant, and it is actually the rate, it is actually the rate when concentration of the reactants are unity. So K is nothing new. It is also a rate. Rate may be of different types. Since concentration may be different, rate may be different. But among all such rates, there is one rate that is the rate constant. And for this reason, since among all rates, a particular rate is defined as the rate constant, the another name for K is the specific rate constant, since it is referring to a particular concentration of reactants. Now, what is the unit of this rate constant? Let us consider an nth order reaction. So n moles of A react to give product. It may be the case that there are two reactants and the sum of the order is n, that is the overall order is n. So we have the rate, that is rate of disappearance of reactant, to be proportional to C to the power n. So K is the rate constant, this is the rate, and the rate is proportional to the nth power of the concentration of the reactant at time t. Now this is the rate equation. Now put here, concentration has the unit mole per liter, and here it is time in the denominator, so we have per second, and here it is mole per liter to the power n. So we have, this is or, mole per liter per second by mole per liter to the power n. So you see, depending upon the order of the reaction, the unit of rate constant is going to vary. So it is the rate constant, but its unit is not constant. It will vary depending upon the order of the reaction. So for zero order reaction, what will be the unit of rate constant? For zero order reaction, this will be 1, so that the unit will be mole per liter per second. And for first order reaction, means this is K into C to the power 1. And for zero order means K into C to the power 0. So it is, the rate is also constant throughout the reaction. Now for first order reaction, this will be mole per liter to the power 1. So this will cancel out and we will have only second inverse. This second inverse may be minute inverse or hour inverse. Now for second order reaction, it will be 2 here. So 1 will cancel and another will remain in the denominator. So when it comes to the numerator, it will give us mole inverse liter per second. So there will be mole per liter
liter inverse will go to the numerator and will give liter, and this will be mole inverse. So these are the units of rate constant. Now characteristics of rate constant. Characteristics of rate constant. In the first point, you see that K carries the signature of a particular reaction. That is, for a particular reaction, there is a definite K. So when we vary from reaction to reaction, this K will vary, showing that K is a characteristic of a particular reaction. But keep in mind that it is a function of temperature. So K depends on temperature. So when you compare the rate constant values of different reactions, please keep the temperature constant. Otherwise, since K depends on temperature, K will vary. Now, so long as the temperature is constant for a particular reaction, there will be a particular value of K. So at a constant temperature for a definite reaction, there will be a definite K value. Now what will happen to K when we increase the temperature? K increases when temperature is increased. This I have explained to you in previous parts, that if this is a reaction energy profile, this is energy. Now there are reactant molecules which have to cross this energy barrier. Now when you increase the temperature, you are pumping heat within the system. So when the thermal energy enters into the system in the form of heat, that is going to increase the thermal energy of the constituents, of the reactants, and the reactants will be eligible to cross this barrier more. So that is going to increase the rate constant. So more the temperature, more will be the rate constant. And more the rate constant, more will be the rate. Since rate equal to K into C to the power m, so more the temperature, more will be the rate constant, and more the rate constant, more faster the reaction will happen. Now its unit. This unit may vary, and it depends on the overall order of the reaction. Now another thing, how we determine rate constant? We put C equal to 1. So rate constant is the rate when concentration is taken to be unity. So it must be independent of the initial concentration, since it is defined at a particular concentration. So another important characteristic of rate constant is the rate constant K is independent of the initial concentration, generally symbolized as C0. It only depends on temperature and is a feature of a particular reaction only.